So among a few reasons for bleeding your brake line is, firstly, you might have air bubbles in your system and you need to get rid of them, or you want to replace the fluid completely. Either way, usually results in inefficient braking. Your brake lever feels soft and spongy, or your brake lever goes all the way to the handlebars and your brakes don't work very well at all. So you need to bleed your brake line. So in this video, I'm going to show you how easy it is to do with just a few tools. So let's fix your brakes and bleed your brake line.
Pulling on your brake lever moves the push rod in. Like a plunger, it pushes on the non-compressive fluid. The fluid in the hydraulic line moves towards the caliper. In the caliper, the fluid pushes pistons inwards. Sitting on the pistons are brake pads, which contact the rotor disc, causing friction and slowing you down. Air bubbles in a line normally float upwards into the master cylinder through the fluid inlet port into the reservoir. Once here, they won't affect the integrity of the brake system. Even with a lot of air in the reservoir, it still can't get back down into the inlet port, unless your bike is turned upside down, but we'll cover that later on. These are all the tools you'll need, and these ones here are specific to bleeding a line. You can either buy them separately, or they come in a bleed kit. They're pretty cheap to buy off of eBay, AliExpress and places like that, and they usually come with extra bits which can come in handy in the future. When bleeding a line, it's all too easy to spill some of the brake fluid on either your rotor or the brake pads, and this will greatly deteriorate the braking efficiency. Disc brake pads absorb lubricants very easily, causing your pads to slide over the disc instead of grabbing. And it's almost impossible to remove or leach out the lubricant from the contaminated pad. The longer you leave the lubricant on the pad, the further it gets absorbed. And even if you're very careful and don't get any lubricant on your brake pads, but some gets on the rotor braking surface, when you apply your brakes, the lubricant's going to transfer to your brake pads anyhow. So, when bleeding a line, it's best practice to remove the wheel and the brake pads. First, remove the wheel for the brake line that you're working on. Looking at the caliper from the inside, you'll see a small clip. It's called a snap ring that needs to be removed. It's very small and you can lose it easily, so put it on a tray or in a container. Now returning to the front of the caliper, remove that bolt. It's called a pad axle. And it's usually a flathead screwdriver or an Allen key to remove it. Now pinch both brake pads together, pull backwards, and they'll slide out. So you have a left and a right brake pad and a spring. Now insert the bleed block into the caliper. This will keep the pistons at the right distance apart, even if you accidentally press on your brake lever. Open the bleed port cap, or if you need better access to the bleed port, remove the cap altogether. Attach the tubing to the syringe and then fill it with about 50 milliliters of the hydraulic fluid. If you're not sure what fluid your brakes use, this guide should help. If you suck up air bubbles, make sure they float to the top and that there's none stuck in the tube. Attach the 7mm spanner to the bleed port. Take the syringe and tube with the hydraulic fluid in it and attach the end of the tube to the bleed port nipple. Give it a bit of a wiggle, it should be a fairly tight fit. If you find the hose leaks fluid at the nipple, use a hose clasp. Put it on the hose first before you attach the hose to the nipple. If you're using a thicker spanner like I am, you probably won't be able to use the hose clasp, but as long as the tubing fits on well onto the nipple, it won't leak fluid. If you happen to trap a bubble in the tube, let it float up the tube into the top of the syringe. If you tie the syringe to the frame with a rag, it keeps it in place and it will give you another free hand.
Now peel back the lever hood to reveal the bleed screw.
Remove the bleed screw with the Allen key. Be careful not to lose the little washer underneath the screw head. Screw the funnel adapter into the thread, which is actually the top of the hydraulic fluid reservoir. and then screw the funnel into the top of the adapter. Now open the bleed port with the spanner. It only needs to be about a quarter to a half a turn. You may get some small air bubbles come out of the caliper. Let them float up, not back into the caliper, as you press the fluid into the caliper with the syringe. Because the portal hole is only small, it may seem a bit slow as you push the fluid into the system. If you want, you can stop at any time, look into the funnel, and see that the fluid is indeed flowing upwards. You may or may not see air bubbles appearing in the funnel. Once you've put in 50 to 60 milliliters of fluid, close the bleed port with the spanner. Remove the tube from the bleed port nipple and the syringe away from the bike as well, and wipe off any excess spilled fluid with a tissue, paper towel or rag. Then pop the bleed port cap back on. Before you remove the funnel from the brake lever, squeeze the lever to make sure no more air bubbles come up into the funnel, and that the lever should have a solid braking feel. Highly unlikely, but if your lever still feels spongy, then you still have air in the system somewhere. All you need to do is simply repeat the bleed process and it should be fine. Put the plunger in the funnel and make sure it fits properly so that fluid doesn't leak out. You'll need something to rest the funnel on once it's removed, so here's two suggestions. You can use a plastic fruit juice bottle, cut it so that the top and the bottom fit neatly together, then you can rest the funnel in it without spilling any fluid. It's also handy for fitting the tube in it to drain the fluid out of it. Simply pull out the plunger and allow the funnel to drain. Wipe off the plunger and the funnel and they're ready to be used for another time. As long as the funnel fits nicely in the opening, you can use almost any container. And you can wash it out and reuse it again. Right, now you can unscrew the funnel and sit that in the container, and then unscrew the adapter and wrap it in a tissue. You'll notice that the fluid level will be right up the top. That's okay. So now grab your bleed screw and simply screw it back into place. As you do the screw up, some of the fluid will spill out, so dab it off with the tissue as you go. Don't over tighten the screw. It's only a small 2mm Allen head, so you don't want to strip that out. So 1 to 2 Newton meters would be firm enough. Wipe off any excess fluid and then fold the lever hood back into place. And back down to the caliper now, and you can now remove the bleed block. If you suspect there's any spilt fluid, you can give it a wipe with the tissue. Then reinstall your brake pads. The spring goes in exactly the same position as when you took it off, and usually there's a left and a right brake pad. There's an easy way to remember this. As you ride your bicycle, on your left side is where the left brake pad goes, and of course the right one goes on the inside of the caliper. Insert the pad axle, and you may need to wiggle the brake pads a bit to help it go through. Screw it all the way in, and lastly, put on the snap ring. If you're bleeding Shimano brakes, like in this video, you'll be using mineral oil. But do you have to use Shimano mineral oil? In fact, which mineral oil can you use? There are lots of mineral oil products on the market, but probably the most widely known is baby oil. It's fragranced mineral oil, but can you use it in your brakes? Check out Seth's Bike Hacks. He's been using baby oil trouble-free for over 8 months now, and almost all his viewers' comments on using baby oil agree. It works a treat.
Something that happens quite often is if you store your bike upside down, or you travel with your bike upside down, or whatever reason, you turn your bike upside down even to clean it or fix it or something, it's upside down for a while. Then when you go and turn your bike up the other way, you find your brakes are not working very good. It's gone all spongy. Oh no, what's happened? Well, all that's happened is there was air in the reservoir up the top, which is where it should be, but because your bike was upside down, it's floated down through that little gap back into the handle itself, through the plunger area, and then into the system. So somewhere you've got those air bubbles back in the line or in the system. So all you need to do then is just hold your bike up, use your front hand, just tap your cables a little bit like that, work your brake lever, just keep working it, and get that air bubble or air bubbles back up into the top of the reservoir where they should be, and your brakes will be fine. Now, if you find that your 2mm Allen key goes round and round and round in the bleed screw, that means you've stripped the tooling size, the Allen head in the bleed screw itself. So what you need to do then is get yourself one of these. It's an easy out. This one's a 3mm easy out. And so you can just put that in and screw it out as normal, and it bites in and it will pull the screw out. Then, of course, you're going to have to buy yourself a new one. Why Shimano make it only a 2mm, I'll never know. It should be at least a 4, but anyhow, that's how you get it out. So, all done. And your lever feels nice and firm, and your brakes are strong again.
Nothing ammo. You alright, mate?
Oh, that was like insane.